Alright, welcome back. Of course, we're going to play first with this deck. What do we have here? This hand is about as normal as it can get, but we have a really early Sundering Titan via Grand Architect here. Like, super early. Can I get on turn? I might be able to get on turn 4. This is 6 mana. Yeah, I can get on turn 4 if I draw one land in the meantime. This hand has like none of our accelerators, and it's kind of funny. Our opponent's playing a 45 card deck, it looks like. It's odd. All right, welcome back. This is again round one of Holiday Cube. I'm Conley Woods, and we have a sweet hand here. Just gonna play turn two Strix. Our deck doesn't have a ton of card advantage. We have an Ancestral Visions, a Tezzeret that can get us some cards, and then we have a lot of things that just kind of replace themselves, like Baleful Strix. So let me shut that off. All right, he's preordaining. He might have a little brew too. We did pass a Brain Freeze. I would have taken Brain Freeze over Tendrils, but because it's sealed, it's 40 cards, so it's basically the same card, but half the mana. But at the same time, I can't complain too much. We can actually beat a Brain Freeze if we have Academy Ruins in play. Opponent is taking forever. Alright, it is officially our turn. We could do the Signet play. I kind of like the Baleful Strix because we get to see more cards, and it's a blue creature for Grand Architect. So when I play Grand Architect next turn, I can immediately play this Signet and potentially something else. Or I could Trinket Mage. Either way works. I probably should Trinket Mage before Grand Architect because. Ooh. Can I just. Let's see. I play Grand Architect. I go up to 4 mana. Well, I can do many things. If I just play Trinket Mage, that's the safest by far. I get a Mox or Soul Ring, either one. Then the next turn I cast my guy. Otherwise, I can go Grand Architect, play Grand Monolith, play Dimir Signet, play Sword of Iron Ice, go. And the next turn I'll have Titan as well. Yeah, I'm just gonna do that. I could actually attack for two instead, but I'm gonna. Actually, alt you. Undo. If I tap this for three. Play this. No, I need it. Okay. That was my turn. Alright, so I untap. I have access to 8 mana for Sundering Titan. Wouldn't just kill my swamp, blow up all his lands. I think this is about the fairest draw our deck can have, to be honest. We're still doing some cool things, but In the way my deck ended up, I think I would have rather had the Mana Crypt over the... Or, I'm sorry, the Mana Vault over the Sword of Fire and Ice, but it is what it is. Alright, so we're going to... I can actually play this guy. Because that's 6, 8, yeah. Get a Soul Ring. Play a Soul Ring. That's where we're at. Don't balance me, please. We did pass a balance. I took Time Walk instead. I'm still not even sure about that, but I guess we didn't play white, so. Could I have untapped? I could have untapped this. I guess I would have retapped it that turn, so it doesn't really matter. Yeah, even if he balances with sword in play, three different mana artifacts, and then Sundering Titan's gonna be taking his lands. Alright, it's taking forever. I'm gonna go ahead and pause it again. Alright, let's see if he has balance. No, he's got an Orzhov Signet. Probably not gonna be good enough. That's a Time Walk. I think I just kill him, right? I guess I should turn this guy into an artifact, because why not? Or into a blue creature. It's one extra damage. Untap, take an extra turn. Our opponent gets to say mercy. Alright. We didn't really see much out of him. He did have an artifact. I don't want to bring a disenchant or white mana for that matter. The Sphinx being pro-green, pro-red probably doesn't matter in this matchup either. So I'm just going to keep it as is and we'll be back for game two.